Good morning. Our focus, cash flow statement. Our focus is now cash flow statement. Shall I? Okay. What is this cash flow statement? Okay. This statement specifies the inflow and outflow of cash from various activities. This statement specifies the inflow and outflow of cash from various activities. Okay. Company law makes it mandatory for all companies to provide cash flow statement as part of their annual report. Company law makes it mandatory for all companies to provide cash flow statement as part of their annual report. Accounting Standard 3 Accounting Standard 3, Accounting Standard 3 specifies the format and method of reporting cash flow statement. Okay, it gives you the format as well as the method in which it has to be reported. Okay. The standard also specifies the various ways in which activities ought to be divided for the purpose of reporting. before even going into the flow statement, let us understand how to prepare some working notes. Okay? Heading, preparation of working notes. In your notebook, the heading, preparation of working notes. Roman 1, fixed assets. Roman 1, fixed assets, hyphen, WDV method, written down value method. What is written down value method is, depreciation is charged in the asset account itself. Okay? There is another method called cost method, where you will separately maintain an account called accumulated depreciation. You will not charge the depreciation to asset. In the WDV method, the entry for depreciation is depreciation account debit to asset. In the cost method, the entry for depreciation is depreciation account debit to accumulated depreciation account. You will not reduce it from the cost of the asset. You will maintain depreciation as a separate account. So, and the first one is WDV method. We will do some examples, and these examples are going to tell us how cash flow will behave. Okay? How cash flow will behave and how we have to interpret this cash flows. Am I clear to you? Okay? The first example, my dear friends. Example number one. Example number one. Okay? Opening balance of plant and machinery, 26 lakhs. Opening balance of plant and machinery, 26 lakhs. Closing balance of plant and machinery, 25,80,000. Closing balance of plant and machinery, 25,80,000. Under that, purchased a new machine at the beginning of the year, 3,70,000. Purchased a new machine at the beginning of the year, 3,70,000. May I, my dear friends? Okay. For example number one. Okay. Let us prepare the ledger account for the given example. Whenever I purchase an account, asset to bank, what can be the balancing figure? What can be the balancing figure? Sales cannot be the balancing figure. Sales and depreciation can only be the balancing figure. Okay. Total, I hope you can all understand it. Okay, I'm not doing the total. You will do the total in your notebook and close the account. Please do the total in the notebook and close the account. Is this understandable to the class? Okay, right? Now, when I analyze this, okay, please understand, depreciation is a non-cash item. That is, it does not result in physical outflow of cash. இப்போ நான் salaries, என்னோட P&L debit side salaries, is it a physical outflow of cash? Yes. Rent, administrative expenses, selling expenses, various interest, all these things are physical outflow of cash. Whereas when I say to depreciation, it does not result in physical outflow of cash. அதனால என்ன ஆகுது அப்படின்னா, இப்போ நெட் ப்ராஃபிட், ஓகே, இன் திஸ் எக்ஸாம்பிள் லெட் அஸ் டேக் தட் தி நெட் ப்ராஃபிட் இஸ் 5 லாக், ஓகே, வி கால் கேஷ் ப்ராஃபிட் அஸ் 8,90,000. நெட் ப்ராஃபிட் இஸ் 5 லாக் ஆஃப்டர் ரெடியூசிங் டிப்ரிசியேஷன் ஆன் ஃபிக்ஸட் அசட் டு தி எக்ஸ்டென்ட் ஆஃப் இன் திஸ் கிவன் எக்ஸாம்பிள் 3,90,000. In this given example, 3,90,000. I am reducing 3,90,000 and giving you a net profit of 5 lakhs. Is this 3,90,000 a cash outflow for me? No. So, when I want to find out my cash profit, what will I do is, I will add back this 3,90,000. Or, when I want to know what is my cash inflow, I sold for, let us take 40 lakhs. And made a net profit of 5 lakhs after charging depreciation, means before charging depreciation, my profit will be known as cash profit. Is the class clear? So analysis, in that write down, depreciation is a non-cash item, hence needs to be added to profit to identify cash flow. Depreciation is a non-cash item, so I will add it to my profit to find out my cash flow. Is the class understanding? Analysis 2, I am writing here, but in you, 2, okay, I am writing, just for sake, I am writing it here. Second, purchase of asset results in cash outflow. You all agree with me? Purchase of asset results in cash outflow. So, when I prepare an asset account, I can easily bifurcate between A, what is going to be my non-cash item in the asset account, that is depreciation. If there is a purchase, I would have paid money, got it, so it results in cash outflow. If there is a sale, I would have received money, so it will result in a cash inflow. Is the class clear? Okay, right. Example 2, friends. Example 2. opening 3120, closing 3080, purchased a new machine at the beginning of the year 370, sold an old machine whose written down value is 110,000. I have sold it for 95,000. I have sold it for 95,000. Is the class clear? Is the class clear? May I move on? Okay. Ledger account, get ready. My dear friends, opening balance or balance brought down. Balance brought down 31,20,000. Bank, that is purchase of asset. Bank, nothing but purchase of asset, 370,000. 370,000. Is the class following? Okay. Here again, bank, that is nothing but sale of asset. Okay. Sale of asset, my dear friends. Sale of asset, 95,000. P&L, nothing but loss from sale of asset. How much? 110,000 is the book value of the asset, minus sold for 95,000. So 15,000 is the loss from sale of asset. I got it. She gave me. Okay. 15,000 is the loss from sale of asset. Okay. 15,000 is loss from sale of asset. Is the class following? Is the class following? Okay. My closing WDV is making the worst mistake. My closing WDV is 30,80,000. 30,80,000. So what is the depreciation I will be charging? How much? 3 lakhs. Is the answer clear to yours? Okay. Is the answer clear to the class? This is my balancing figure. That is the depreciation of 3 lakhs. The depreciation of 3 lakhs. I'm not going into totaling. You are doing it in your notebook. Analysis. My dear friends, analysis. How does this work? Analysis. Please understand. Is depreciation a cash item? No. Is loss on sale a cash item? ரெண்டுமே எனக்கு வந்து cash outflow இல்ல. I had a machine which is worth 110,000. I sold it for 95,000. It doesn't mean that 15,000 cash has gone out of me. No. It doesn't mean so. Okay. Both depreciation and loss on sale of asset does not result in cash outflow. So if I want to find out my cash profit from my net profit, I need to add back both these things. Is the class clear? So analysis one, okay, depreciation and loss on sale of asset are non-cash items. Hence, needs to be added to profit. Are we following? Is the class clear? Nada Raja. Is the class clear? May I move on? Is this clear? So whenever I prepare my asset account, I will be able to map what will result in cash outflow, cash inflow, and what are all the items which will not have any impact on the cash flow. So if I take the net profit, I will add it back. Example number 3, take down. Why am I doing this mistake? Thank you. So the balancing figure here will be purchase. Okay, the balancing figure here will be purchase. Is it 360,000? Is it 360,000? Okay. How is the analysis going to work now? How is the analysis going to work now? Please understand, depreciation is a non-cash item to be added to the profit. Purchase will result in cash outflow. Sales will result in cash inflow. Profit on sale of asset is again a non-operative income. That is non-cash. That cash you would have received. But it is a non-operative income which will be again reduced from the profit. Okay? Somewhere else I will add it up. I will show you when we come to the performance. The cash inflow will be taken but somewhere else. May I? Okay? Is the class clear? Example 4. Opening balance is 62,50,000. New machinery purchased and used for 9 months. So the depreciation will be proportionated 21,40,000, rate of depreciation 15%, and old machinery whose WDV is 210 was sold for 185. Analyze, my dear friends. Thank you. for those of you who are listening in the recording also, do the question. I'll only do the analysis now. Okay. Sai Lakshmi, question cancer put. No, it's not live. Okay, may I, my dear friends, okay, right, I'm writing whatever Vijay is saying, we'll check it up, okay, one. Depreciation, may I know the quantum? 1146750 is a non-cash item to be added. Two.
Purchase,
okay, may I know the quantum?
21,40,000.
It's given, right? Depreciation is the balancing figure, right? Purchase will result in cash outflow and sale in cash inflow. Okay, third.
Loss on sale of asset,
may I know the quantum?
25,000
is a non-cash item. Okay, that is like the first one. Okay, okay. May I know the closing balance?
70,320.
Which is the balancing figure? Okay,
70,33,250.
Anybody having a different answer, let me know. Go ahead with your answer.
Evlo vardu raja.
7,78,000. What did you assume it as? So your answer is changing, huh? Okay.
End of the year.
You have taken end of the year. So for those, the depreciation will be, okay, you will be doing 62,50,000 into 15% plus 21,40,000 into 15% into 9/12. You have assumed sale to be at, yeah, you already, you have done it as 60,40,000 into 15% plus 21,40,000 into 15% into 9/12. So this answer, that is this depreciation answer, will be correct if it is a, if it is assumed as beginning of the year. Okay, if, okay, now I'll take your answer. If sale is at end of the, at the end of the year, then depreciation will be 11,78,250 and closing balance will be
70,1,750.
Okay, I get, take both the answers. I should have given, I accept that I should have given. My intention was at the beginning of the year only. My intention was not to charge depreciation on sale, but I take that, I take both the answers. I should have given, I take both the answers. Is the class clear? Shall I move on? Yeah, yeah, take your time. You want me to work out and show? You're clear, right? Is the class clear? May I move on, friends? Okay, right. I'm furthering into the examples. Now I am going to Roman 2. Fixed assets at original cost. Why?
Because profit, if it is at the end of the year, then it will be profit on sale of plant.
Okay. Got your point. Maintain it. I should have changed the question. No problem. Now, Roman 2, fixed assets. At original cost. Under that, write down the theory. In this method, which is what companies are following, my dear friends, in this method, Depreciation will not be charged to the asset account but maintained separately. Depreciation will not be charged to the asset account but maintained separately in accumulated depreciation account. It will not be charged to the asset account. It will be maintained in accumulated. So normally I pass the entry depreciation to asset. Here I pass depreciation to accumulated depreciation. Ana balance sheet la varumbodhu what I will do? Fixed asset, original cost, less accumulated depreciation. Okay. I will have it as two lines. Not that accumulated depreciation is a liability and all. It will be there in the balance sheet and it will be reduced. Now, provision for bad debts, Mari. Though I create the entry bad debts account, I mean P&L to provision for bad debts, but obviously what I do is that provision for bad debts will be reduced from the debtors and the net balance will only be shown similarly. Am I clear? Okay. In this case, I'll go example wise. Example 5. Okay. The building has an opening balance and a closing balance of 90 and 1 crore 10 lakhs respectively. Accumulated depreciation is 1 crore 60 lakhs and 2 crore 5 lakhs respectively. Okay. Okay. Yeah, sorry, sir. Your daily? Till? Okay, you listen to the then and there listen that there is. Shall I, my dear friends? Shall I? Okay. My ledger account will go like this. Okay. Building account. I mean example number 5. Opening balance is 90 lakhs, okay, and the balance carried forward, that is the closing balance, that is the closing balance is 1 crore 10 lakhs. So the difference is nothing but bank, nothing but purchase of asset. Okay, depreciation will not affect this account at all. Okay, so this will be the balancing figure. This will be the balancing figure, nothing but purchase of asset. Purchase of asset. Is the class clear? Is the class clear? Okay. The accumulated depreciation account. It is more like a liability account. So the balancing figure will be, balance brought down will be on the credit side. The balance brought down will be on the credit side. 1,60,000. 1,60,000. The closing balance of balance carried forward will be on the debit side. Will be on the debit side. 2,05,000. And the only reason it has changed is due to the depreciation charged during the year. The depreciation charged during the year. Okay. This year's depreciation is the reason for the change. Is the reason for the change. Because I told you the entry will be depreciation account debit to accumulated depreciation. Inga dhaan the entry a park panuvaanga. Okay. They will not park it. They will not charge it to the asset. They will come it and they will come and take it to the accumulated depreciation account. Is the class clear with this? Is the class clear? Okay, this is how the account will behave, and we know the analysis. Analysis remains the same. Analysis is not undergoing any change. Depreciation of the current year is a non-cash item to be added to profit for identifying cash flow. Which one? Yeah. Normala rendu entry eppadi irukumna depreciation account debit to asset, P&L account debit to depreciation. Here also, the second entry is the first entry is depreciation to accumulated depreciation, whereas the second entry is P&L account debit to depreciation. It will obviously go to depreciation P&L account. May I? Okay. My dear friends, that's example number six. Okay. The same values almost, okay, but with a different building. Opening 90 lakhs, closing 95. Accumulated depreciation 16 lakhs and 16 lakh 10,000. An old building whose original cost is 10 lakhs. Accumulated depreciation 2,10,000 was sold for 3 lakhs. Change this along to 8 lakhs. Okay. Is the class clear? May I take over? Okay. So, friends, understand. Okay. Building opening 90, closing 95. Accumulated depreciation 16 and 16,10 respectively. An old building whose original cost of 10 lakhs and accumulated depreciation of 2,10,000 was sold for 8 lakhs. Now the whole class, we have a particular format to work. Okay, I don't know what you followed in your school, I don't know what you followed in your college, but we are going to follow this particular format only in our CA examination, in our classroom. Okay, we are going to follow this particular example number six. First, building account. balance brought down 90 lakhs. In the opening, I had 90 lakhs. Class, in the opening, I had 90 lakhs. What happened is, during the course of a year, I have sold a building whose original cost is 10 lakhs, which is there in this opening. Which is there in this opening. Now I have to take it out. Now I have to take it out. Please understand, I have to prepare this account. So, asset disposal account. I will transfer it to an account called asset disposal. You can understand the word disposal means selling off or taking it off. Asset disposal account, 10 lakhs. Is the class clear? Okay. Balance carried forward. Is the class clear? Okay. Okay, this is accumulated depreciation opening balance where I have accumulated over many years, and it will include an accumulated depreciation for machine that has been sold. Okay, so that I am transferring it to asset disposal account. How much is that? 2,10,000. 2,10,000. Is the class clear with this account? Okay. I have the opening WDV of accumulated depreciation. Current year depreciation will go to that account only. If I have sold any asset of the past years, adodi accumulated depreciation, that asset's accumulated depreciation should be taken off from this. Is the class clear? Okay. Asset disposal account. Okay, from the building account, from the fixed asset account, how much we transferred from the fixed asset account? 10 lakhs. From the accumulated depreciation account, okay, I transferred 2,10,000. I transferred 2,10,000. Is the class understanding? Now it technically means, okay, 7,90,000 worth of asset. The WDV is 7,90,000 is sold for 8 lakhs. Okay, so bank is 8 lakhs, so it will result in profit and loss account, nothing but profit on sale of asset . Is the class completely clear how to do this account? Okay, 3 accounts. Whenever, let me give it to you as a ground rule. I don't know how you have worked it in your school or college, but I will tell you, whenever they give you original cost and accumulated depreciation, we need to prepare 3 accounts. We need to necessarily prepare 3 accounts. Asset account, the accumulated depreciation account, and asset disposal account. Never skip this format. Okay. And now you know, I'm not writing because now you know, this bank is a cash outflow. This depreciation is a non-cash item. Okay. This bank is a cash inflow and this profit is a non-operative income. I will take it out while computing my operational cash flow. While computing my operational cash flow. Is the class completely clear with the concept? Okay. Question number 7, example 7 is yours. Is this the answer you are also getting? Is this the answer? All of us are getting this answer. Any doubts? Any doubts we are, okay? However information they give, we can decipher that information and prepare these accounts so that we should be very clear how to prepare the fixed asset account and how the fixed asset account will behave in cash flow statement. This is cash outflow. This is non-cash item. This is non-cash item. This is cash inflow. Okay? Okay? Now I am going into Roman 3. Okay? Provision for taxation. Provision for taxation. Okay. Other information being constant, or where there is no information, then it is always assumed. Then it is always assumed that the previous year's provision is paid during the current year, and current year provision is newly created. Other information being constant, or where there is no information, then it is always assumed that the previous year's provision is created, is paid during the current year, and the current year provision is always newly created. And the current year provision is always newly created. Other information being constant, my dear friends, okay? Other information being constant, I'll tell you what it is. Or where there is no information, then it is assumed that previous year's provision is paid during the year and this year's provision is newly created. Is newly created. My dear friends, for example, it looks like this. Okay? Provision for taxation. Opening balance 11 lakhs, closing balance 14 lakhs. Okay? This is a constant information also. There is no other information also. Then it is always assumed this opening, okay, and this is closing, okay. Then it is always assumed that this is paid during the current year. Actually, 31st March, we will know what is the profit. So, April to March year. Appadhaan enakku profit theriyum, appadhaan enakku tax theriyum. Return file pandrathukula I will pay. So other things being constant, this will be paid during the year and this is created newly. This is created newly. Okay. So for paying, the entry will be provision for taxation account debited to bank. It results in cash outflow. For payment, the entry is provision for taxation account debit to bank. For new creation, the entry will be P&L account debit to provision. For new creation, the entry will be P&L account debit to provision for taxation. Is the class clear? Okay, right. Now, as a ledger account, how this will behave? First, as a format, I am giving you. First, as a format, I am giving you. It's a liability, my dear friends. It's a liability. Okay? It will have the balance, okay, on the credit side. On the credit side. Okay? Then comes this entry called profit and loss account debit to provision for taxation. Okay? So, nothing but current year provision. This is nothing but current year provision. Okay? To bank. Okay? Last year provision paid or tax paid. That's all. It can be, need not be last year provision paid. It is tax paid. Okay? And balance carried forward. Balance carried forward. Okay? Okay? This is cash outflow and this is just a non-cash item. It is not, it is just a provision. Only here I pay it, whereas here it is only a provision. Are you understanding? Okay, take down this format, please.
Opening closing by the
example. Huh? Adu? Is the class clear? Okay, I'm sticking on this example. I'm sticking on opening 11 lakhs, closing 14 lakhs. Okay, tax paid during the year. Tax paid during the year. Okay, let us take it as 12 lakhs. Tax paid during the year, 12 lakhs. Tax paid during the year, 12 lakhs, my dear friends. Okay, okay. Is the class okay? Shall I, my dear friends? Okay. In the same format, I will work out and show you. Here it will be opening balance of 11 lakhs. It will be opening balance of 11 lakhs. Here will be tax paid during the year, which is 12 lakhs. Which is 12 lakhs. Closing balance will be 14 lakhs. 14 lakhs. So what is created during the year, what is created during the year will be, okay, current year provision will be 15 lakhs. Current year provision will be 15 lakhs. Is the class following? Is the class following? The current year provision will be 15 lakhs. Solda Raja. Last year provision lapa, tax paid during the year. Any doubts? Any doubts? Shall I move on? Shall I proceed, my dear friends? Is the class clear about this provision for taxation? The behavior is very simple. It's a simple account. Okay? It will have only four things: opening, closing, paid, created. Created is a non-cash item. Paid is a cash outflow. Like, we are not worried about opening, closing in terms of cash flow, but to know what is paid, what is, we need to prepare this particular account and see. Am I clear to you? Okay. Roman 4. Dividend. Roman 4. Dividend. Roman 4. Dividend. Okay. Proposed dividend will behave in the same manner of provision for taxation. My dear friends, proposed dividend will behave in the same way in which I gave you provision for taxation. Proposed dividend will behave in the same way in which provision for taxation. No information means last year dividend paid now, current year dividend is newly created. Okay, it will behave in the same manner in which, okay, it is, okay, interim dividend is the amount paid during the year, because that is what is interim dividend. Whatever is declared and paid between two financial years, okay, between the closure of two financial years, is popularly known as interim dividend. So there is no specificity for that. That is what is paid. Is the class clear? Okay. Are we all following? Okay. I am going back to more theories now. Okay, now accounting standard, you can say format of preparation. Accounting standard 3 specifies that cash flow statement will be divided into 3 activities. Operational, investment, and finance. Accounting standard 3 says that cash flow statements will be divided into 3 activities, which are operational, investment, and investment activity and finance activity. Is the class clear? Is the class understanding? Operational activity, investing activity, and finance activity. So I am going to divide the entire CFS into 3 activities. Operational activity will specify the result. Result of cash inflow or outflow on conduct of the main business. friends, operational activity, what it will say is, what will operational activity say is, it will tell me by conducting the main business, by doing the main operation, what is my income or expenditure. Okay, what is my inflow or outflow, sorry. What is my inflow or outflow? By doing the main activity, what is the inflow or outflow is done by operation. You can, in our financial management, we would have studied operational profit. What is the main profit? Okay, profits are always divided into various shapes. Gross profit, buying and selling alone, or manufacturing and selling alone, whatever profit I get is known as gross profit. Cash profit, whatever is the profit purely in terms of counting of money. Okay, that is known as cash profit. Depreciation la add pannu paapom. Net profit, after charging all expenditure on resources, which may not be our outflow of cash. Okay, that is known as net profit. Okay, operational profit, it's also a term where I am not charging the long term items or non cash items. Management ku in the profit avlo, management ku what is going to be the in net result. So like that we can divide the profits into various shapes and understand. Here I am, my operational activity is cash flow from the main business. By conducting the business, what is my cash flow? Okay, and the cash flow enakku negative ah iruka. The company might have net profit, but the company can have negative operational activity. Vice versa also. Okay, majority of the dot-com companies which you are seeing, my dear friends, starting from your ready for anything, are not profit rich company but cash rich companies. Avangaludaya profit negative la irukum ana cash positive la irukum, especially their operational, because they are still investing in the technology. அது ஒரு அசட்டுக்கு தான் அந்த கேஷ். ஓகே, ஸோ தே ஆர் ஆல் நோன் அஸ் கேஷ் ரிச் கம்பெனிஸ். தே வில் ஹாவ் அ ஹியூஜ் கேஷ் பேலன்ஸ், பட் த டிப்ரிசியேஷன் வில் ஆல்சோ பி ஹை ஃபார் தம். ஸோ தட் இஸ் வாட் இஸ் திஸ் தட்ஸ் வை ஆபரேஷனல் ஆக்டிவிட்டி இஸ் அ வெரி இம்பார்ட்டன்ட் டு அண்டர்ஸ்டாண்ட் ஹவு த கேஷ் பிஹேவியர் இஸ். இஸ் த கிளாஸ் கிளியர்? ஓகே, நெக்ஸ்ட் இஸ் இன்வெஸ்டிங் ஆக்டிவிட்டி. Okay, will result in cash outflow or inflow or outflow on investments made in assets/securities. Investing activity will specify the cash inflow or outflow on investments made in assets or securities. Third is finance activity. Finance activity will specify the inflow or outflow for the owners, that is the shareholders and long-term stakeholders. Now, FM, financial management, or even in costing, you would have studied a concept called capital employed. Capital and capital employed are not the same, correct? கேபிட்டல் ஒன்லி ஷேர் கேபிட்டல், கேபிட்டல் எம்ப்ளாய்ட்னா ஷேர் கேபிட்டல் பிளஸ் லாங் டேர்ம் பாரோவிங்ஸ். ஓகே, ஒரு டிபென்ச்சர்ஸ், we are issuing a debentures for 10 years. Okay, அது வந்து நம்ம வந்து ஒரு ஷார்ட் டேர்ம் பார்க்க கூடாது, அதுவும் இட்ஸ் சார்ட் ஆஃப் அ கேபிட்டல். The only difference is it is a repayable capital. That's all. Share capital, I am not going to repay unless my company is liquidated. Whereas these type of long-term capital, debentures, bonds, இதுவும் capital தான். With the only condition, 10 வருஷம் கழிச்சு I am going to repay. But it will also constitute capital. Here my finance, I will classify them as my finance activity. Long-term borrowings from bank. Bank gives me a loan for 20 years. அதெல்லாம் எனக்கு லாங் டேர்ம் ஆக்டிவிட்டி தான். ஃபைனான்ஸ் ஆக்டிவிட்டி வில் ஸ்பெசிஃபை த ரிசல்ட் ஆஃப் இன்ஃப்ளோ அண்ட் அவுட்ஃப்ளோ டு த ஓனர்ஸ் அண்ட் த லாங் டேர்ம் ஸ்டேக் ஹோல்டர்ஸ். இஸ் த கிளாஸ் கிளியர்? ஓகே, இஸ் த கிளாஸ் கிளியர்? Accounting standard 3. Okay, gives the option of preparing CFS either under direct method or indirect method. Okay, AS 3 gives me the option of preparing cash flow statements. AS3 gives me the option of preparing cash flow statement either by using the direct method or by indirect method. AS3 gives me the option of preparing my cash flow statement either by direct method or by indirect method. Okay. My dear friends, 9 out of 10 companies will only prepare it in indirect method. 9 out of 10 companies will only prepare it in indirect method. Direct method is little complicated practically. But in examination, direct method is the easy method. But from the examination perspective, direct method is the easy method. So easy method, I'll keep it on the last day of the class. Okay, I don't want to start with the easy method. Let me go to indirect method. இது வந்து நீங்க banking மாதிரி, insurance மாதிரி, consolidate format accounts இது. Okay, this is a format which is prescribed. In the format prepare பண்றதுக்கு we might do some working notes. Okay, like fixed asset account etc. But technically speaking, this is a format account. The format has been mentioned in the standard itself. May I start? Okay. Format of preparing cash flow statement. Indirect method. Format of preparing cash flow statement, indirect method. Cash flow statement of dash 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 limited. For the year ending, it's for the whole year, so it's not like balance sheet on a particular day. For the year ending dash dash dash. Okay. Particulars, amount, neat lines please. Particulars, amount. Draw neat lines. from operational activities. May I, my dear friends, may I? For this also, this is under indirect method, I start with net profit as the basis. Okay, net profit as per profit and loss count for the year ended. Add transfer to reserves. So after getting the profit, some portion of the profit I might transfer to general reserve. The entry is P&L account debit to general reserve. It like the cash account. It is a book entry. This is a book entry. So it has no impact on my cash flow statement. Transfer to reserves. Provision for taxation. Nothing but here I am meaning current year provision. Nama example la nama potom. Okay. That is in the example we did, if you remember, current year provision. Whatever is the current year provision, I will add back. Proposed dividend, proposed slash interim dividend. Proposed slash interim dividend. Am I clear to you? Am I clear to you? Okay. I add all these things, I get profit, sorry, net profit before tax, net profit before tax. Okay, okay. Okay, friends. These three are known as appropriations. These three, what we call in our accounts is appropriation. Appropriation means between the owner and the entity. Okay, these three are, so all appropriations, first I will add back. All appropriation items, first I will add back. These three are popularly known as appropriations. So all appropriations, I will add back. Is the class clear? Okay. Less. Extraordinary income, if any. I'll tell you. You have a question, I'll answer it. Is the class clear? Is the class clear? Okay, right. So this is net profit before extraordinary items. Now what I am going to do? Don't write it now. We will write the items, put it here in the margin. Now what I am going to do is add back all non-cash and non-operative items. Non-cash and non-operative items, one by one I am going to, okay? Depreciation. Okay? It's for intangibles, we call it as amortization. Is the class following? Okay. Depreciation, amortization, loss on sale of assets, miscellaneous expenses written off, that is preliminary expenses, first year 10,000, next year 5,000. Goodwill on the amortization la vandru. Okay. So that 5,000 will be added back. Okay. Am I clear? Is the class clear? Okay. Right. These are all some of the things which we will add back. These are all some of the things which we will add back. And also there is something known as reduction. Okay. That is. No, sorry. Also there is something known as non-operative. Interest on long-term borrowings. I will add back. Because all long-term borrowings, we all know that is. It will go to finance activity. It is a cash outflow. I am not denying that. But it goes to finance activity. So I will add back. I will add back interest on long-term borrowings. Interest on long-term borrowings, I will add back. Is the class understanding? Okay. Right. There itself, I will write. Note. Interest on working capital loan will not be added back. Interest on working capital loan will not be, because it is a short term borrowing. This overdraft, cash credit, in the mari irukkadalla short term borrowings I need not add back. Only interest on long-term borrowings will be added back. Is the class clear? Am I communicating? Are you all understanding? Okay. So, interest on long-term borrowings will be added back. Okay. Further, based upon question to question, if there are some other items, we will look into it. Depending on that question, we will look into it. Okay. Right. When I say loss on sale of asset, I not only mean asset, I also mean investment. Okay. Loss on sale of asset, I also mean loss on sale of investment. Okay. Right. Then less profit. Profit on sale of asset or investment. Okay. Profit on sale of asset. Or investment. Profit on sale of asset or investment. Interest income / dividend income received. Okay. Interest or dividend. Okay. This is on investment. Interest income or dividend income received on long-term investments. Interest income or dividend income received on long-term investments. Is the class understanding? Are we clear in this class? Okay, friends, this is the first time we are going to use a term called, okay, cash flow before change in working capital. Cash flow before change in working capital. Cash flow before there is any change in working capital. Cash flow before change in working capital. Cash flow before change in working capital. Now I am going to talk about change in working capital, friends. Now I am going to talk about change in working capital. Okay, the simplest things I can make you understand is, okay, if the opening balance of debtors is 10 lakhs and the closing balance is 9 lakhs, other things being constant, this year you have collected 1 lakh. Okay? Right? In terms of creditors, if the opening balance is 15 lakhs and the closing balance is 12 lakhs, other things being constant, this year you have paid 3 lakhs. Okay? From here, if I extrapolate and see, okay? A reduction in current asset will be beneficial to the cash. Cash has flowed in. Okay? Giving two examples from here, I am extrapolating to the whole concept as such. Whenever current asset reduces, cash balance increases. Whenever current asset increases, cash balance decreases. Whenever current liability decreases, cash balance also decreases. Whenever current liabilities increase, cash balance increases. Out inflow is there. Inflow is two ways. Physically collecting, stopping an outflow. Rendume inflow da. Physically collecting is also an inflow. Stopping an outflow is also amounting to inflow. So, decrease in current asset and increase in current liability will be my inflow. You all agree with me? Decrease in current asset, increase in current liability will be treated as inflow. Vice versa concept. Increase in current asset, decrease in current liability will be outflow. Is the class clear? Is the class clear? Any doubt, please ask me. Okay, so going back to the format, what now I do is decrease in current asset, it will be always an inflow. You feel it cold? Okay. Increase in current liability, that will also be positive. Increase in that will be negative. Is the class completely clear? Is the class completely clear? Okay. So now I will hit at a point of cash flow after change in working capital. Is the class clear? Shall I move on? And extraordinary income. Add pandu thirupi adha raja. Okay. Add extraordinary income less tax paid. இந்த ப்ரொவிஷன் ஃபார் டாக்ஸேஷனில் அக்கௌண்ட்டில் இங்கே நீங்கள் பெய்டு இன்கம் டேக்ஸ் பெய்டுன்னு ஒன்று இருக்குது. ஓகே, டேக்ஸ் பெய்டு வில் பி ரெட்யூஸ்ட், டேக்ஸ் பெய்டு வில் பி ரெட்யூஸ்ட் அண்ட் திஸ் பாயிண்ட் இஸ் பாப்புலர்லி நோன் அஸ் கேஷ் ஃப்ளோ ஃப்ரம் ஆப்ரேஷனல் ஆக்டிவிட்டி. Cash flow from operational activity.
If there is a doubt, ask me.
Please see the video for tomorrow. Raja, before coming to tomorrow's class, please see the video. Huh? But that's a big time. Is the class clear? From the top I am going. First I took out all the appropriations, I added back. Then added and reduced non-cash and non-operational items. Depreciation, amortization, loss, miscellaneous expenses written off or non-cash. Interest on long-term borrowings to be added. Interest or dividend income from securities should be reduced. Profit on sale. These are non-operative. Okay? Non-cash, non-operative items. Then comes the working capital. The easiest methodology of understanding working capital is to understand your asset, debtors and creditors. If debtors reduces, cash inflow, extrapolate that. Decrease in current asset will give me cash inflow. the opposite concept. Increase in current liability will also give me cash inflow. Decrease in current liability, creditor reduces, which means I have paid. So that will result in outflow, the reverse concept. So all these things you will do and you will find change for cash flow after working capital change. Again, whatever you reduced as extraordinary income, add it back here and then tax paid, you will get cash flow from operational activity. What is an extraordinary item? Insurance claim received on destroyal of asset, or insurance claim received for stoppage of some activity, flood, okay. இதெல்லாம் ரெக்கர் ஆக போகுது இல்லை, அதனால வி கால் இட் அஸ் எக்ஸ்ட்ராடினரி ஐட்டம். பட் இட் இஸ் நாட் அன் ஆபரேஷனல் கேஷ் அவுட் ஃப்ளோ. ஓகே, இட் வில் நாட் பி அ ஆபரேஷனல் கேஷ் அவுட் ஃப்ளோ. இஸ் த கிளாஸ் கம்ப்ளீட்லி கிளியர்? ஓகே, ஸோ திஸ் இஸ் ஹவு த ஆபரேஷனல் அவுட் ஃப்ளோ இஸ் கம்ப்யூட்டட். Now I am going for the second thing, investing activity. Because of investment, what happens? Okay, sale value of assets, we all know, we did it just now. Any asset sale value, okay, I'll hear itself add sale value of assets or investments, that is long term investments, sale value of assets or long term investment will result in cash inflow. Sale value of assets or long-term investments will result in cash inflow. Dividend or interest received from investments. Okay, dividend or interest income received from investment. Is the class clear? Is the class clear? Okay, right. அவள்கிட்ட ஆசீர்வாதம் வாங்கி தான் போயாடா ராஜா, எக்ஸாம் எழுதுறதுக்கு. பெரிய விஷயம்டா ராஜா. Purchase value of asset, okay, because of purchase it will result in negative cash outflow, negative cash outflow. The answer of this will be known as cash inflow, or I mean cash flow from investing activity. Other companies, shares, securities, debentures, everything. cash flow from finance activity. Okay, proceeds from issue of shares or debentures. Proceeds from issue of shares or debentures. The word used by me is proceeds, which will include both share capital and premium. Which will include both share capital and securities premium. Proceeds from issue of, okay, proceeds from issue of shares means, shares or debenture means, both the share capital and the premium. Is the class clear? Is the class clear? Okay, long term borrowings. If I get any other loan which is of long term nature, long term borrowings, that is also an inflow. That is also an inflow. Repayment of long term loans. Repayment of long term loans. Repayment of long term loans. Is the class clear? Okay, when I repay a long term loan, it is a cash outflow. Okay. Redemption proceeds, which means capital plus premium, okay, of preference shares or debentures. Redemption proceeds, which is nothing but capital plus premium of preference shares and debentures. Redemption proceeds of preference shares, which is cash capital plus premium. Okay, interest paid. Okay, nama finance activity la we added it. Finance activity la interest on long term borrowings we added it. Here we will reduce. Okay, dividend paid, which will be final plus interim, proposed dividend plus interim dividend, which is paid. Is the class following? Is the class following? Okay. Now I hit after all the three activities are over. Okay. I hit that net cash flow, which is nothing but A plus B plus C. Okay. Cash flow from investing activity plus finance activity plus operational activity. Okay, opening balance of cash and cash equivalents. Will automatically lead me to an answer of It's an automatic answer. You should automatically get this. Closing balance of cash and cash equivalents.
Take your time to look into the format patiently from the top to the bottom.
Is the class clear? Are we all understanding? Okay. Shall we start doing tomorrow the questions? Okay. Tomorrow we'll meet there at 9:30. 9:30 to 12:30 full of indirect method questions. Okay. Meet you tomorrow morning. All the very best, friends. Mm-hmm.